Purdue researchers found that up to half of all high school football players suffer brain function impairment even without ever getting a concussion.
The question that comes out of that is whether or not these deficits that we're observing, these impairments, have long-term consequences.
Purdue wired a local team's helmet with accelerometers to send data on every hit to a sideline computer. Players received up to 1,800 significant head hits per season, some ranging up to 200 Gs. That can be like falling three stories head first.
The helmets only protect against skull fracture right now. They don't claim to prevent concussions.
Cognitive tests and fMRIs before, during, and after the season showed diminished visual memory results and reduced brain function.
What's actually happened is that this area is now effectively not active during the two-back task. It's no longer being recruited by the body to perform the task.
The lack of sideline symptoms frightens the researcher, who was a Purdue football trainer.
Those players remain on the field, continue to take blows to the head, and maybe magnify this damage or this deficit that occurs.
The researchers hope to examine whether high school kids experience the elevated protein levels connected to the debilitating CTE brain disease.
Hips together, eyes up.
They think players need to be taught better blocking and tackling techniques. Eventually, they may need to be benched after a prescribed number of head hits. At Purdue University, I'm Jim Shank.